Hello guys, last time we talked about the Japanese heavies. This time we're going to go a little bit more into detail about them and what are the strong sides and the weak sides of them. Also, what is their usage in the WGL. So I hope you're going to enjoy this video because I think it's a good one. You can see the Type 5 and Type 4 share the same gun, but the stats are better on the Type 5. Also, armor-wise, the Type 5 is slightly upgraded version of the Type 4. It also gets a ton of extra HP. In WGL, this is mainly used to replace the slow British DDs because of the fact they have a turret and armor, and they still have that big alpha. It can also be used as a cap block, but you will see examples about all of that. The Type 4 and Type 5 share pretty much the same weak spots. The flat surface on the turret next to the gun mantlet on both sides, then the flat surface on the center of the hole across the entire area, and the flat surface on the bottom of the hole are spots that are penetratable. It works well against regular shells, but it will struggle against premium ammunition. When angling, the same problem occurs. There is still flat surface that can be shot, and premium rounds and even AP rounds won't struggle to pin it. We said the Type 4 and Type 5 have big alpha. This is the perfect example of it. You can see how the Type 4 delivers a massive blow to the lightly armored Batshot for 1155 damage. It's the perfect use for a Type 4 or Type 5 on such a position. We'll take a look at a different example here. Keep in mind, he spotted the Batshot and the Batshot spotted him in return. Let's look at Isuba's tactic first. You can see how Overus is on the cap and he is covered by three tanks from behind who can deliver shots down the B-line. Then there is one guy who can cover 8-line but can rotate quickly to help B-line if needed. Tomasek in the Type 5 can shoot both B-line and D-line depending where his team needs him. Last but not least, the Batshot up the hill who can spot the entire courtyard section. So back to the T10 here. You can see how he resets but went down after. This happened because the Batshot from the hill spotted him, the guys turned their guns and quickly managed to move him. All because the Batshot spotted him crossing, and you can see what the Type 5 did to him. Now let's take a look at Type 5 and how it can be used on mines. But first, let's go over the tactic used here. Ding's tactic is pretty much a center rush to take control over that big middle hill. They have a gorilla in the back who can shoot the D4 cubby where usually a TVP from the attacker goes, so he can deliver 750 on towards his side. Last but not least, they have two heavies who are pushing towards the center of the hill. This is so they can crossfire if the attacker tries to counter push the hill, and that's exactly what the attacker will go for. You can see here the attacker Oops is going for the counter push we talked about. They will have to take the middle against the Type 5 though, so let's listen and see how it goes.
You have to take this Type 4 heavy shot!
Guys! Oh, he shot me! Oh my god.
You could hear how the heavies were supposed to take the shot, but they didn't. The Batshot got hit by the Type 5 for 1300 and finished off by the T-49. Not ideal for Oops whatsoever. Normally, the heavies should take the shot because the Type 5 can't bend them because of the 75 penetration on the gun. What it is good at is splashing, but don't forget from last time to be careful because you could easily splash your friendly tanks in the process. Like I said last time, make sure there are no friendlies in the area when you do decide to take that shot. For Himmelsdorf, the Type 4 and Type 5 have multiple uses, but let's take a look at splash first. So this is the moment the 113 should realize he's in trouble. The mouse gets spotted on the hill. You can see here there is multiple tanks on the hill which are starting to splash the 113. It's one of the best usages of the HE ammunition. Best comparable it is to an RT gun. Even when you don't hit the shot, you can splash somebody. So even if you can't directly hit them, you can splash by shooting next to them or under them. Alright guys, just watch and enjoy how the 113 gets barraged by a rain of high explosive shells. Different situation here on Himmelsdorf, where an IS-4 is in a position that is used a lot in WGL because you can side-scrape over there and reset the cap. Too bad for the IS-4, side-scraping doesn't work against the Type 5 Heavy, as he doesn't need to pen, he just needs to hit him with his high-explosive gun. You can see even though the Type 5 only sees the track from the IS-4, he can still do a nice amount of damage by hitting it. You guys remember what I said earlier about Splash? Watch this and see the perfect example of how he can splash a tank even though the IS-4 went unspotted. He was able to predict where he was playing and was able to get a splash connection on towards him. You can see here where the shot hit next to him on the ground and how much damage it actually did. Again, another connection from the Type 5 on towards him, pretty much resulting in a dead IS-4. Tactic ruined. This is the second usage of the Type 4. It's to block in the camp. Because of its size, it's the perfect tank to make a shield so somebody can sit behind him and camp. You could see how the mouse went first to take the initial damage to make sure the Type 4 made it onto the cap safely and surely. You can see how the Type 4 will make it onto the cap and turn sideways in order of the T10 to sit behind him and start the cap. Let's take a look at the overall tactic used by Ding on this map. So Meritorious is shielding on the cap here, making sure nobody can reset from the 1-2 line. And this will force the entire attacking team to go down the 3 line in order to get those resets. Positive in the mouse door is blocking off that angle, but he's not alone. There's two tanks on towards the D line as well, which is Breakneck and Kurit, who can get shots onto the crossing tanks, creating a deadly crossfire. Remember, in the beginning we talked about the armor weak spots of the Type 4 and Type 5, and the flat surface, which is penetratable, is the best example of it. You can see that this shot from the front also knocked out his Amorak from the front. That's pretty impressive. But you can see here where it pinned exactly. The flat surface we talked about, and that is why side scraping in this tank isn't as effective as the mouse, for example. The Type 4 wants to try again. He's going in for the second time. He's trying to side scrape again. He lines up for it, but it doesn't go and it won't go any better than last time. He gets Amoraked once again from the front, but this time he got hit in the flat surface on the other side. You can see here the three times he got pinned was on the flat surface, which we pointed out as a weak spot in the beginning. It's why side scraping in the type really doesn't work, because you always have to expose a weak spot no matter what you do. As always guys, I hope you found this video entertaining and it showed you a little bit of how the Japanese tanks can work and how they sometimes can't work. I hope this makes you understand a little bit better how their usage works into the WGL, and as always, see you on the battlefield.